Hello there, geographers, and welcome back to the Mr. Sin channel. In this video, we'll be talking about situation factors, but we're going to be going a little bit more in depth than past videos. We're going to be focusing actually on the different transportation methods that are used for all industries. Now, while this video is going over the different situation factors focusing on transportation, it's important that you understand what the situation factors are and also site factors. So make sure you've checked out my other videos before watching this one. You can click the cards in the top right to go check those out. If you haven't seen them yet, go watch those, then come back to this one. Also, while watching this one, I definitely recommend using the guided notes. You can find them in the description below. They'll go right along with the video and help you better understand everything. I'll be going over a lot of information pretty fast, so it helps to take notes so you can remember all the important concepts. Now, in talking about ways we ship goods around both our cities, our states, our nations, and even the globe, we can break all of it down into five main categories of shipping. We have trucks, we have trains, we have planes, we have ships, and we have pipelines. And it's important to understand them all. They all have different pros and cons that make them more advantageous in some situations and also makes them a little less effective in other situations. So in trying to understand exactly what method of transportation to use, we have to make sure that we're maximizing our profits. And to do that, we have to minimize our costs. Remember, industry and companies in general are all about making money. So they're concerned about how they can transport their goods quickly, efficiently, and also cheaply. Now, in order to do this, we have to look at our supply chain. On the screen right now, we can see the supply chain. It's important to understand that each step in the supply chain is going to vary with what transportation we use. Some things we might use the same transportation for all of them, and others we might actually fluctuate depending on the manufacturing process or where we are in the supply chain. As kind of a general rule of thumb, normally the heavier the item is, and also the more bulkier it is, that's going to cost us more to ship it. And at the same time too, the further we're shipping goods, normally we'll see then a reduction in the amount it costs to ship it per kilometer. So that's kind of important to understand. While it might seem like an easy, simple decision, just pick one form of transportation that costs the least, there's a lot of factors that go into it. The two main ones that companies are actually factoring in is the unload and load time. How long is it going to take to transfer the products between one method to another? And also the distance that needs to be traveled. Now, a really important concept you definitely need to know is actually break bulk points. This is where companies can actually transfer from one method of transportation to another. A perfect example of these points would be an airport or a seaport, where we could actually have, theoretically, a ship come into a port, they'll unload the goods, and then the goods could be loaded onto a different method of transportation, like a truck. A lot of companies will use these if we're seeing larger distances traveled. This can help us in trying to get our goods to market really fast, or even to a factory. Now, there is different things that these add to the cost. One, we have to pay people to take things off of one method of transportation and put them onto another, so that can add costs. And at the same time too, we might have to actually get temporary storage in order to hold things, so that could also add costs. So those are important to understand. But companies and industries are always looking to try and minimize their costs when transporting goods, and they have to sometimes use these break of bulk points in order to be able to get their goods to where they need to be. Let's actually now go into the different methods of transportation to try to better understand when we would use each one. In order to respect your time and to help you use your time as efficiently as possible, I'm not going to read everything that's going to be on the screen. In fact, I'm actually going to kind of skip over most of the pros and cons for each of the different methods of transportation. That's to help keep the video shorter and hopefully help you use your time more efficiently. But make sure you are taking notes on the different pros and cons. If at any point you need to pause the video, feel free to pause it and take down your notes, then unpause it. So our first method of transportation we're going to go over is trucks. Now, trucks are very popular with transporting goods, and the reason why is they're pretty efficient, and they're also pretty cheap, especially if we're looking at something that's about a day's journey. So if I'm transporting goods and it's just going to take a day's drive, well, trucks are normally what are used. That's because they have very quick unload and load times. that can help keep costs down and help get our goods right away to the consumers. So it's a very practical way for companies to deliver goods. And at the same time too, it's not even just a longer distance, for example, a 24-hour drive, but shorter distances as well are used. So that's important to understand. Now I'm going to go on to the next method of transportation. So if you need more time to record the wonderful pros and cons, pause the video now. Our next form of transportation that industries use is trains. Now trains are really important and are actually used a lot if the trip is going to be over a day in length. And that's because this is a pretty efficient way to be able to ship a lot of materials at a relatively quick amount of time. Because trains, for the most part, aren't going to have to stop at different locations. This is used most commonly when shipping things in very long distances. For example, in the United States, from coast to coast, industries will use trains. And that's because it'll help keep their costs down and can make sure that their goods all get as quickly as possible to their desired locations. Now, if you need more time to understand the different pros and cons, make sure to pause this video. If not, it's time to go on to the next form of transportation. So far we've only talked about different forms of transportation that work with land. The next form though is ships. The big advantage here and the big reason why ships are used is because now we can travel extremely large distances and we can go between continents. This helps us with our new globalized market. The world has continuously become more and more connected. And now our markets are not just even local, but now they're international. So ships become a really important part of transporting goods. This helps companies no longer just focus on their own clientele that is regional, but now we can focus actually on an international stage. Now, if you need more time to check out the different pros and cons, again, make sure to pause the video as we go on to our next form of transportation. Our next form of transportation is airplanes. Now, airplanes are one of our more expensive forms of transportation, but they're used for items that are normally smaller bulk items because airlines only have so much capacity, and also for items that are extremely valuable. Now, the reason why they're used for extremely valuable items is because actually to cover some of the cost of actually shipping with an airplane, because it's pretty expensive to do so. Also, we'll see airlines used when we have to have things delivered very quickly. So if we're traveling a long distance and it needs to get there relatively fast, well, airlines are the one thing that companies can use. Now, check out the pros and cons with this one because those are important to understand. One thing that is possible to transport by airlines that other methods it's not is actually perishable items. And that's because of the speed that airplanes can transfer goods between one location and another. Our last method of transportation is one that's pretty different than the rest we've talked about. And that's because this one is pretty specific. Pipelines are only going to focus really on just gases and liquids. All other types of goods really can't be used with a pipeline. But pipelines are important to understand because they can be used for long distances. Pipelines can go in between different countries or in between different states, and they can help us transport things relatively fast. Now, once they're set in place, really we can't move them, so that's a disadvantage there. But pipelines are used today to be able to transport things across large distances. I hope by now this is starting to make more sense. Both the pros and cons for all these different methods of transportation, why an industry would pick one method of transportation over another, or even maybe why they would switch between a transportation method. If you need more help with any of this stuff with our economic unit, make sure to ask me in the comments below. Again, I'm Mr. Sin. This is AP Human Geography. I hope this video helped you better understand these different concepts. And until next time, I'll see you online.